Recording on. Is my voice clear? Can be clearly heard over there?
Yes, sir. Sir, I have a question, sir.
Yes.
There are no surprises, right, for today's meeting.
Huh? What do you want?
Is there a surprise?
You want a surprise? Yeah,
no, I can arrange.
Sir.
I'm just
no, 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 sir, sir.
No, sir. No, no.
No, sir.
I'm
just no, asking.
It depends if you are be active and responsive. Yeah, maybe no need for
okay, we will be
okay,
need for surprise. But if you are quiet, sleepy, maybe I will send a surprise.
Oh, don't, sir. Don't, do not.
Yeah, I have the book next to me, so I just take one question.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Sir, no need, sir.
Yeah. Okay. Yes. Let's continue first because we have a semester to catch. So I've checked the portal. So if we have finished until this week, we have just finished 32 hours. So there are still 10 hours left, yeah, for your lectures. So it means maybe we can still cover the operational amplifier chapter on that account. Okay, so today we are going to discuss about Thevenin equivalent circuit when both dependent and independent sources are there. So in last week, we have discussed separately, when only independent sources are there, and then we have also discuss the circuit with only dependent sources in the circuit. So today, what if both are there inside the circuit? So we are going to discuss how to determine the Thevenin equivalent source as well as the Thevenin equivalent resistors. Yeah. Well, basically afterwards, then it will be quite easy to determine also the Norton equivalent circuits, because the Norton equivalent resistor is the same as the Thevenin equivalent resistor, and the Norton equivalent current source can be determined by dividing the Thevenin equivalent voltage source by with the Thevenin equivalent resistance. Okay, so a linear circuit may contain independent and dependent sources here at the part A, let's say to the left part where it is going to be replaced. Yeah. Then it is connected to terminal A and B, and then the output voltage from that terminal is VO, a V output, and the current I is going out from the terminal A. Okay, So now this part A can be replaced with an equivalent voltage source, Thevenin voltage source in series with an equivalent Thevenin resistor. Yeah, of course, again, we can always from here, then we can similarly change this into equivalent Norton resistance, and change this into a current source, basically the same, like this, AB. So this become the RN, Norton equivalent resistance, which is basically the same as the Thevenin equivalent resistance. And this is I Norton, which is basically can be calculated from VTH divided by RTH. So you can, depending on the circuit, you can either find using Norton first or Thevenin first. After that, then you can find the other equivalent circuits. Okay, let's clear the drawing. So VTH here, if we have discussed, the Thevenin equivalent voltage source equals to the open circuit voltage between the terminal A and B. And the terminal Thevenin equivalent resistance equals to this open circuit voltage divided by the short circuit between A and B. So we first find the VOC, open circuit voltage, and then we find the short circuit current, ISC. After that, we can calculate RTH by dividing the VOC by ISC. So we will compute open circuit voltage and short circuit current. For each determination of Thevenin equivalent, we will solve two circuits. Any and all, so it means what the soft the two circuits are. The first one is when the terminal is made open circuit, and the second circuit is when the terminal is made to be short circuited. Yeah, from there, we will obtain the open circuit voltage and then the short circuit current. Dividing the open circuit voltage with the short circuit current, we can find the Thevenin equivalent resistance or the Norton equivalent resistance. Any and all the techniques discussed should be readily available. That is the KCL, KVL. So when solving those circuits, we can use KCL, KVL combination, series and parallel, voltage divider, current divider, node analysis, loop analysis, source superposition, source transformation, homogeneity and linearity, etc. You may use any techniques that you have found and you have learned so far. Okay, the approach of setting to zero all sources and then combining resistances to determine the Thevenin resistance is in general not applicable. Okay, so in previous session we have learned that we can also find Thevenin resistance by setting the voltage in the part A, in the part A circuit, setting the voltage source to be short circuit and the current source to be open circuit. But that is only applicable when it contains only independent sources or when it contains only dependent sources, in which case then we will apply arbitrary current source or voltage source at the terminal AB. But in general, when we have circuit with both dependent and independent sources, this approach of setting to zero all sources is not applicable. So we have to find VOC and find ISC. Okay, first is open circuiting the part A, the A terminal AB, and then calculating that the voltage across that AB terminal. And secondly, we short circuit the terminal AB and then find that current flowing through that wire AB, ISC. From there, then we can calculate RTH equals to VOC divided by ISC. So be careful with this principle. So for example, use the Thevenin to determine V output here. Okay, so here we have both independent source and dependent source, the 12 volt independent source and 2000 IX dependent source, current dependent voltage source. Okay, so the problem is always where to divide the circuit, to make partition of the circuit. Yeah, you can make, for example, at this point, yes, but simpler maybe at this point, yeah, between A and B. So the AB terminal before the 1 kilo ohm becomes your terminal of part A, which you will replace with Thevenin equivalent circuit. Then after that, if you find already the VTH and RTH, the voltage across this 1 kilo ohm, you can calculate using voltage divider formula. So part A should be as simple as possible. That is the guideline. So this becomes the part B, the part which is encircled by the red line. After part A is replaced by the Thevenin equivalent, we should have a very simple circuit. So this is the guideline. So you have to make sure that when you simplify or find the Thevenin equivalent circuit of part A, after it was found, then when it is connected to the rest of the circuit, it should be a simple circuit, not too complex, so that then you can easily find the V output at that part B. Yeah, the dependent sources and their controlling variables here must remain together. So here, IX is when we choose part B to be in this part between encircled in this part. Yeah, so IX is still included in part A. So do not then make part B to be, for example, for between this point and this point, because then IX will be already outside of that part A. Okay, so let's make this as an open circuit voltage. So to calculate the VOC, so here A and B here, so like this, and then we can use any techniques which you have learned so far. What are the options? You can choose here node supernode analysis, right? KCL, using KCL. The constant is at this supernode. So from here, V1 minus VOC. So this part is basically equals to this node, yeah, equals to the V open, open circuit. The ground is at this bottom node. V1 negative VOC equals to 12 volt. So V1 equals to VOC plus 12 volt. KCL at supernode here. Here is V1 here, 12 V1, yeah. Here V 12 plus VOC, negative this voltage, which is how much is this? AIX dash, yeah. AI, A is 2000, yeah. The voltage here is negative, yeah, because this is negative. Negative AIX divided by 1K. Plus here, 12 plus VOC minus 0 divided by 2K, yeah, to form here. Plus here is VOC divided by negative 0 divided by 2K equals to 0. So equation for the controlling variable is this one, IX, yeah, IX, I dash X flowing through this 2 kilo ohm resistor, that current equals to VOC, V open circuit, divided by the 2 kilo ohm. Okay, then solving that, the VOC equals to, solving for this part, yeah, it equals to negative 36 divided by 4 plus A divided by 1K. Okay, so we replace this IX into the, substitute this IX into this first equation. So from there, then we obtain this equation. VOC, so A is here 2000, okay, 2000 IX. From that, then second part is short circuiting this terminal between A and B. So what is the current flowing through here? So VA, again, I double dash X equals to the VA divided by 2K, okay. So simplifying here, from here, then we can simplify this 1K. Yeah, so this is 12 volt, and then this is the short circuit current, and then this is the two kilo ohm here. Then the I short circuits equal from here equals to the negative 12 volt divided by 1K parallel to 2K. Yeah, this is in parallel. Basically, this is in parallel and in series with this one. So we obtain negative 18 milliampere. So from here, the Thevenin equivalent resistance is the VOC divided by short circuit current. Yeah, this voltage. Yeah, divided by negative 18 milliampere. So we obtain 2 divided by 4 plus A divided by 1K kilo ohm. Setting all sources to zero and combining resistances will yield an incorrect value. So if, for example, in the previous session, we always learn to calculate RTH by setting this into short circuit, right? And this also short circuit. And that is not working here. So that is not the general principle. That will only work if you have only independent sources or only dependent sources. But if you have both independent and dependent sources within the part A circuit, you should find VOC, open circuit voltage, then find ISC, short circuit current. After that, finding the RTH by dividing the VOC by the ISC. Okay? That is the method to find. So, So from here, then we replace the whole circuit, yeah, left to the left of this part V with this VOC. VOC is 36 here. If we replace A with 2000, yeah, so 2K did become 2. 4 plus 2 is 6. 36 divided by 6 is 6. So here is negative 6 volt. Okay. Then the RTH here is 2. This is 2. 2 divided by 2K divided by 1K is 2. 2 plus 4 is 6. 2 over 4 is 1/3 kilo ohm. So here is the Thevenin equivalent resistance connected to 1 kilo ohm and 1 kilo ohm. So this is basically a simple voltage divider formula, right? So from here, then you can calculate using voltage division. This is RTH, yeah. So when A equals to 2 kilo ohm, okay, and this is the VOC, and V output equals to 1K divided by 1K plus 1K plus 1/3 kilo ohm times this VOC. Okay, okay, another example.
Sir. Yes. I have a question. Why VA divided by 2K is 0?
Which one?
Why VA divided by 2K is 0 in the middle?
Can you make annotation which one, which part you are asking?
I dash dash X.
You can annotate in the screen, please.
This one.
OIX double X equals to VA divided by 2K.
Yes.
Okay, good question. Oh, this one, yeah. I understand why this one equals to zero. because when you are making a parallel circuit, right? It is basically voltage division circuit. Yeah, let me share. When you have a circuit like this, let's say this one is V1. R1 and R2, right? Correct?
Yes.
Yes.
Who's asking? Okay. Wait. What is the previous one? Yeah, current, right? Current. Okay. Doesn't matter. Current. So there is current flowing through here, I2, let's say I2, there can flowing through here, I1. So the formula is what? For current flowing through I2 is equal to, this is current division.
R1 over R1 plus R2 times V1.
Huh?
R1 over R1 plus R2 times V1.
R1?
V1.
Yes.
V1 divided by R2. V1 divided by R1 divided by R1 plus R2.
Yeah, V1 divided by
R1 over R1 plus R2.
Like this?
Yes, yes.
Okay. So this is V1 R1. Are you sure? So first you have to find the current flowing through here, right? This current. Let's say this is the current. I here equals to V1 divided by R1 R2 divided by R1 plus R2, right?
Right, sir.
Equals to V1 R1, R2. After that, I2, this is current divider, yeah, but this is voltage source, okay? then I2, this is then you can maybe equals to wait. Yeah, I2 is basically directly, yeah, can be calculated directly V1 divided by R2, right?
Yes.
Betul ya? Correct ya? Then I1 equal to V1 divided by R1. Okay? Or from here, from this, then I2, okay. If it were a current source, right? I2 equals to, we can replace V1 divided by R2 as I, right? I divided by R1, R1 plus R2. Is it correct? I got confused. Tell me if I'm wrong. Yeah.
I think it's wrong.
Wait, this is I2, right? This is correct, right? This part is correct.
It should be V, not I.
Yes, correct. Yeah, you're right. So this should be V, V1, yeah?
Yes.
No. What I mean is like this, not like that, yeah? So I2 equals to V1 divided by R2, right?
I think wrong, sir, if I2 equals V1 over R2, sir.
Yeah, let's erase first.
Yes, sir.
So that we are not confused. I2 equals to V1 divided by R2, right? So here, I
yes, sir,
equals
yes.
to... So this part we replace with I2, okay? So it means this is I2 divided by R1, R1 plus R2, okay? Correct, yeah? So if we replace, then I2 equals to I times R1 divided by R1 plus R2. Correct or not? Similarly, I1 will be equals to I is this one, yeah? I times R2 divided by R1 plus R2. Correct? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Yes, yeah. That is correct, sir.
Correct, right? So now, this is current division, right? Current divider, right? Correct, right?
Correct.
So let's now, for example, R1 equals to, what is the previous one? R1 equals to 2 kilo ohm. Okay. R1 equals to 2 kilo ohm. And R2 equals to 0 kilo ohm. Or just 0 ohm. What happened? So I2 will be equals to I times 2 kilo ohm divided by 2 kilo ohm plus 0, right? Equals to I, right? And on the other hand, I1 will be equals to I times 0 ampere. Understand? So on the other way, on the other words, so if I make this short circuited, like what happened in the previous slide, all the current will flow through here, and none of the current will flow through I1. Understand until here? Because of this current division formula. yeah, to answer back. Siapa tadi yang tanya? Who are asking? Nikki.
Nikki. Nah.
So going back to the slide. Since now this is short circuited, right? What does it mean? The current through the resistor here is zero, right? So when there is a, let's say we are assuming that this is a current definer, okay, so all the current will flow through here, no current will flow through IXX here.
Understand? So the current that is supposed to pass I dash dash X passes through I short circuit.
Yeah, not supposed to, but there is no current flowing through that 2 kilo ohm resistor or that IX dash dash. No current because the resistor between A and B is zero. It is short circuited. Okay, according to the current division formula that we have just derived in the whiteboard, all current will be flowing through ISC, will become IC. That's why here this one IX equals to zero. It is, so if it is no current flowing here, we consider it sort of open circuit. That's why all current will flow through ISC. Okay, so since this is zero, then the voltage at the left part, this dependent sources, the current dependent voltage source, IX, this is zero, right? IX double dash is zero. So this voltage source is also zero. If the voltage source is zero, it means it is what? It is a short circuit. Short circuit means just connected directly. So that's why this become 1 kilo ohm. This become 2 kilo ohm in parallel, in which is in series with the resistor here. Okay. So if this is, if you are still confused about this, you can still, you can consider this ISC as a resistor, but the value is 0 kilo ohm here. Okay. And then you can calculate using KCL or using current divided formula, whatever. What is the current flowing through here? If this is 0 kilo ohm in parallel with 2 kilo ohm, and these two are in series with this, right? If they are in parallel, 0 kilo ohm in parallel with other resistor, right? Then according to the parallel formula, what will be the formula? Is 0 K, this times 2 kilo ohm, times 2 kilo ohm divided by parallel, yeah, the parallel equivalent parallel resistance, yeah, 2K plus 0K, right, which is equal to zero. So this is equal to zero, which is basically this connection only between A and B, no current flowing through this 2 kilo ohm resistance. Understood? No response. Shall we have surprise?
Understood, sir.
Eh?
Understood,
sir.
Understand, yeah.
Yeah,
sir.
No response means surprise.
I don't want surprise, sir.
Yeah. Okay. Is this understood or not? Or what is the? Anyone has not understand yet.
I think understand, sir.
Okay. Yeah.
I understand also.
Yes. Basically, it's from the current division formula, which is in chapter 1 or chapter 2, I forgot, okay. But now one of the resistor is made zero. Yeah, it is the equivalent of short circuit, right? So then all current will flow through here. No current flowing through the 2 kilo ohm. Since no current flowing through that 2 kilo ohm resistor, that's why IX dash dash here equals to zero. This one will be equal to zero as well. So this is short circuited. This become this resistor and 2 kilo ohm resistor, and this is short circuit. Okay, if understand, then let's continue further with next example. So we have here 6 kilo ohm. We have 3 volt voltage, independent voltage source, 1000 IX. Dependent source, yeah, on a current control voltage source, another independent current source, 1 milliampere. This value, voltage source, is dependent on the current flowing through that 2 kilo ohm. is 1 kilo ohm, and we have here 2 kilo ohm. So the question is the voltage across this 2 kilo ohm. What to do? So we have to make partition first. Yeah. So we can make this partition, yeah, replacing this into part A, yeah, as the Thevenin equivalent resistance. So first is the open circuit voltage, like this. Yeah. What is the voltage across this 1 milliampere basically? Yeah, the 1 milliampere current source. Okay, so this will be the Thevenin equivalent voltage source. What will be the method? We can use supernode like this. So this is V1. So V1 minus 0 divided by 2K minus 1 milliampere, because this is the current is in entering into the supernode, plus this one, V1 minus minus 3 volt, yeah, divided by 6K equals to 0. Then the control variable, yeah, so here from here we can obtain already V1 equals to 3/4 volt. The controlling variable Ix equals to that V1 divided by 2K. Okay, so 3/4 volt divided by 2K. So we obtain the value Ix. And then to calculate the voltage here, we can use cutoff voltage law. Okay, so minus VTH, yeah, from here, because this is voltage increase, minus VTH, then going here, minus 1000 Ix going here, plus V1 equals to 0. So left like this, yeah, this loop, the loop, yeah. Then from here, Ix is can be calculated from this part, okay. 3/4 divided by 2K is how much? Let's just calculate it. So that 0.75, right? Divided by 2K, 0.75 divided by 2000 2K. So equals to 375, right? Correct, yeah, 375. Then divided by 1000, so times, this is milli, yeah, so times 10 to the power of minus 3. So this is the Ix. So put there times 1000, so this being gone. And then we obtain here VTH. So V1 is how much? 0.75 negative. Here V1 negative 0.375 equal to VTH. So we obtain here 3/4, yeah, basically all is equals to 0.75 equal to VTH. Okay. Then short circuit, find the short circuit current when it is short circuited like this. Okay. So V1. One here equals to 1000 Ix one. So from here, then Ix one. Yeah, where is it? This one equals to V1 divided by 2K. Okay. So when this is short circuited, okay, it means that it becomes the voltage here equals to zero voltage, yeah, remember, because it is short circuited, means no potential difference between the two node here. So this node is connected then to this node, it means this becomes zero volt. Okay, so that is why here V1 equals to 1000 Ix, okay, because it is already grounded. Now Ix one here equals to V1 divided by 2K. Okay. When V1 equals, since if V1 equals to zero, then Ix will be zero as well, using KCL. Okay. Then KCL at this node. Yeah. So ISC the ISC equals to 1 milliampere here plus negative 3 volt from here plus negative 3 volt divided by 6K. Yeah, V divided by 6K equals to 0.5 milliampere. Okay. Now Ix equals to V1 equals to 0. Yeah, V1 equals to 0. Then Ix1 equals to 0. Okay, so this is what, this is open circuit basically. Okay, then the Thevenin resistance will be equal to the V open circuit obtained before this one, 0.375 volt divided by this 0.5 milliampere. So we obtain 3/4 kilo ohm. Okay, 0.75 kilo ohm. Is plus clear all the drawings. So the equivalent circuit now becomes like this: VTH in series with RTH. Then we connect again. We connect back to the original circuit, 1 kilo ohm and 2 kilo ohm here, and we calculate using voltage divider formula. So V output across this 2 kilo ohm resistor is 2 divided by 2 plus 1 plus 3/4. Yeah, the Thevenin resistance multiplied to the Thevenin equivalent voltage source, 3.8 voltage. Then from there, the equivalent resistance cannot be obtained by short-circuiting the sources and determining the resistance of the resulting interconnection of resistors. So this is another warning that we cannot use the method that we had used last week, yeah, where we short-circuit this 3-volt and then short-circuit this dependent source and then open-circuit this one and then try to find the equivalent resistor. That can only be used when the circuit only contains dependent independent sources only, or contains dependent sources only. But when they contain both, so you have to use the general method, which is finding the open circuit voltage VOC and then finding the short circuit current ISC, then calculating the Thevenin equivalent resistance by dividing the VTH by the ISC. Let's do another example. So we have here 3-volt independent source, 2 milliampere independent current source, and then we have a voltage dependent current source here, Vx divided by 2000. Yeah? And the Vx here is the voltage across the 4 kilo ohm resistor connecting the independent voltage source with the independent current source. First, don't panic. Yeah, select the partition first. The question is at the V output. Yeah, we can choose this partition, for example. Okay. Yeah, so this become part B, and until 2 kilo ohm here becomes part A, right? So the open circuit voltage is redrawn again like this. Okay. Now we want to find this V output, V open circuit between the upper part of this 2 kilo ohm resistor and the bottom node. So we can use loops, using loop analysis, two mesh analysis, two loop equations. So the first equation here is minus Vx, yeah, I1 times 2000 equals to a negative Vx plus directly we can, because this is a current source, right? So I1 equals to Vx dash divided by 2000, yeah, because this is I1 here equals to this current source. So I2 here equals to this current source, which is 2 milliampere, the second loop equation. So the control variable is Vx equals to this Vx dash equals to the voltage across this 2 kilo ohm, which is I1 negative I2 times 4 kilo ohm. So from here, then we need to find Vx1 as well as or I1 and I2. We need to find I2. I2 is already found. Okay, so then Vx1 here equals to 2 kilo I1. So because we input the this is from this equation, yeah, Vx1 equals to 2000 I1. So 2000 I1 substituted into this equation, 2000 I1 equals to 4000 I1 minus I2. Yeah. So from here we obtain I1 equals to 2 milliampere by using the value I2 equals to 2 milliampere. Okay. So this is 2K I1 equals to I2. Let's calculate. So 4K I1, if we choose, this is a 2K I1, this moves to the right, I2 equals to 2K ampere. So I2 is, this is not correct. This is I2, supposed to be 2 milliampere, right? Is my calculation correct here, 4K?
I think no.
So this is 2K I1, right? Wait, what is wrong? Can somebody help in this calculation? I2 is correct, 2 milliampere, right? So 2K I1 equals to 4K I1 negative 4K I2. If we replace 2 here, okay, yeah. This is, I think, 2K I1 equals to 4K I1 negative 4 times 4K times it, which becomes 8, yeah. 4 times 2 is 8. So 4 minus 2 is 2, right? Or 2 minus 4 is minus 2, K I1. Equals to minus 8. Yeah, correct. So I1 here equals to 4. Yeah, 4 milliampere. Okay, that's how it looks like. Yeah, sometimes we have to calculate from that. Okay, so it is correct. Then Vx is the I1 is known here. Okay, so to calculate VOC here, basically is I1 times 2 kilo ohm plus 3 volt, right? So we obtain 4 milliampere times 2K, 8 volt plus 3 volt equals to 11 volt. If anyone does not understand until here, understandable, yeah? So then, secondly, we try to find the short circuit current. So we short circuit this part of the circuit. Then it becomes like this. Okay, so now this become Vx dash dash, the voltage across the 4 kilo ohm, and the current here is Vx dash divided by 2000. Using loop equation again, so we have three loops now, I1, I2, and here is Isc, right? The current flowing through here is basically the same as Isc, as if you are putting a current source there whose value is Isc. So here again in I1 equals to Vx dash dash divided by 2000. I2 here equals to 2 milliampere. Then at this third loop, this one is minus 3 volt. Then here is 2 kilo ohm times Isc minus I1, okay, equals to 0. So the control variable is Vx dash dash equals to I1 minus I2 times 4 kilo ohm. Okay, then we solve the problem. I1 is the same as before, yeah, which is 4 milliampere because we calculate using this equation. Yeah, from we replace Vx dash dash here with this 2K I1 equals to 4K times I1 minus I2. So we will obtain the same I1, Then we insert that into this equation. I1 equals to 4 milliampere here, from which we obtain the short circuit current to be 11 over 2 milliampere. Okay. So the Thevenin equivalent resistance is 11 volt divided by 11 over 2 milliampere. We obtain 2 kilo ohm. Okay, now compute this V output using the Thevenin equivalent. So now this Thevenin equivalent voltage source is 11 volt. And in series with 2 kilo ohm Thevenin resistance, then in series with 6 kilo ohm, the output voltage will be calculated using voltage divider formula. Okay, like this. So 6K divided by 6K plus should be 2. Yeah, this is should be 2K, right? Yeah, sorry. So this should be 2 kilo ohm. Yeah. So yeah, so the output equals to 6K divided by 8K times 11 volt. 3/4 times T433 over 4 volt. Okay, that's the value. Okay, so let's have a break first. So we will pause this for a while. So we have here a linear model for a transistor. A transistor is basically, transistor basically function as an amplifier. Okay. And it contains two parts. One part is the source. Yeah. Here the source voltage R1 and then R connected to R1 and R2. And then the second part, the right part is where the output is, where it has a transconductance source, where it has this current source, which is dependent on the value of Vx on the previous part, on the left part. So this is a voltage controlled voltage source. Now, what will be the voltage across the terminal A and B? Yeah, first is, can we model the whole transistor as a Thevenin circuit, yeah, having a Thevenin equivalent voltage source VTH and a Thevenin equivalent resistance RTH. So the alternative for mixed source is that here, so the VTH will be VOC. Yeah, we calculate it from the open circuit voltage. And then the Thevenin resistance here can be calculated from the open circuit voltage divided by the short circuit current. So let's now determine the open circuit voltage. So when the circuit is open for open circuit is like this, yeah, the voltage across this will be equal to this current multiplied by this resistor, right? Current multiplied by R3, and the current flowing through this is, if we look at from this part, from A to B is negative GM times Vx. So the VTH equals to negative GM times R3 times Vx. Now, Vx itself is a variable within the first part of the circuit, yeah, the voltage across R2. And if you look at the voltage across R2, it is basically a voltage divider circuit. So Vx equals to R2 divided by R1 plus R2 multiplied by the source voltage Vs. So then we obtain VTH. We put this, we substitute this value into the Vx here. So we obtain the Thevenin voltage source equals to negative GM times R3 times R2 divided by R1 plus R2 times the Vs. What about the short circuit current? So the short circuit current here, yeah, basically this is a current divider. As we have discussed in the previous slide, yeah, in the previous hour, that if this is short circuited, then all the current here will flow through this short circuited circuit. So no current flowing through R3. So the ISC will be equal to negative GM times Vx, or we replace again, we substitute Vx with the voltage divider circuit on the left part. So ISC equal to negative GM times R2 divided by R1 plus R2 times VS. Then we calculate the Thevenin equivalent resistance, RTH, equals to VOC, this one, yeah, divided by ISC. Okay, this one. Yeah. So minus GM, this one divided by this one, so equals to R3. So here then it means the equivalent resistance, Thevenin equivalent resistance here is R3, and the VTH here is negative GM, R3, R2 over R1 plus R2, VS. Okay. Let's have another sample problem. Find the Thevenin equivalent at the terminals A and B. Yeah, we have this independent voltage source 12 volt. Dependent current source, current controlled current source to IX here, while the IX is the current flowing through the 4 kilo ohm. This is a mixed sources. Yeah, there are dependent sources, there are independent sources. So we cannot calculate RTH by short-circuiting voltage source and open-circuiting current source. We have to instead compute VOC and ISC, and afterwards we can calculate the RTH, the Thevenin equivalent resistance. So what is the open circuit voltage here? We can consider this as a supernode. And here, let's say here I1 is flowing through the 4 kilo ohm. So KCL at the supernode equals to I1 plus IX plus 2IX equals to zero. Okay, so the two 4 kilo ohm resistors are in parallel. So if they are in parallel, so the same current will flow through these two resistors. So I1 equals to IX. So we obtain two IX plus 2IX for IX equals zero. It means then IX equals to zero. Okay, yeah, IX here equals to zero. So here also will be equals to zero. Okay, so the voltage across here will be equals to the voltage here, yeah, which is 12 volt. So this one, it means this I1 also is open circuited. This one is open circuit. This one is open circuit. The voltage across here will be 12 volt. Now let's calculate the short circuit current. Okay, so this is short circuited. Okay, so this is again considered as a supernode. It's an IX here, yeah, because they are the same, 4 kilo ohm. They are in parallel. The IX, the I1 flowing through the 4 kilo ohm here equals to the current here, the IX. So ISC from here, we obtain I. So if we write the supernode KCL as supernode, then IX based from here, right? IX plus IX plus 2IX equals to ISC. Yeah. Because then ISC equals to 4IX. Okay, then using Kirchhoff voltage law at the outer loop, okay, 4K, yeah, 4K times ISC divided by 4, yeah, which is basically IX, 4K times IX or 4K times ISC divided by 4, negative 12 volt here, then plus 6K times ISC equals to zero. Okay, from here, then we can obtain the value of ISC equals to 12 divided by 7 milliampere. Okay, so from here, we already calculated VTH, we already calculated ISC, so the RTH can be calculated by dividing VTH by the ISC, 12 divided by 12 over 7 milliampere equal to 7 kilo ohm. So then, this is the equivalent Thevenin circuit. VTH is 12 volt, RTH is 12 over 7 milliampere. Okay, sorry, RTH is 7 kilo ohm. This is 12.4% mil ampere is the IEC. So if you are, if the question asks you Norton equivalent circuit, then you just need to use the IEC as the Norton current source. So this is will be the IN in parallel with the RN. Okay, this is A, this is B. And RN here equals to RTH. RN, yeah. And IN equals to the ISC. Okay, so this is, this will be here, and this part is, yeah. Basically, they are equivalent. Okay, so let's have another sample problem. Find the Thevenin equivalent at this terminal now between A and B. Okay, this is also mixed sources. There are two independent sources, VS and two VS, and one dependent sources here, a voltage controlled current source here. So mixed sources, we must compute the open loop voltage and the short circuit current. So here the open circuit voltage is, this is already open circuit, okay? So VTH basically is equal to VX, yeah, VA minus VB, right? Or VA here equals to VX, yeah, the voltage across this R resistor. Yeah, so then VTH equals to VX minus VB. For the VX, we can use voltage divider formula. So VX here equals to R divided by 2R plus R times 2VS. Okay, R divided by R plus 2R times 2VS, or R divided by 3R times 2VS, so equals to 2/3 of VS. Well, VB, we use KVL across, in this loop, okay? So, VB here, the voltage on this current source equals to 2R times the current, AVX plus VX, VS, VS, yeah? So this will be equals to 1 plus 4 AR divided by 3 VS. Okay, divided by 3 VS because we replace VX here with the value from here. Okay, so if we calculate ourselves, it is equals to 2R A. VX equals to 2/3 VS, right? Plus VX. So this equals to, this one becomes one, this part. So one plus this one is 4 over 3, yeah? 4 plus 4 over 3 A times R. Times 2R. Times VS. Okay. Okay, then from there, the VTH will be equal to VX minus VB. So this value, 2/3 of VS negative this value. Okay. VX negative this 2RAVX plus VS. So this will be equal then to minus 1 minus 2RA times 2VS divided by 3, yeah, which is this value, negative VS. Then VTH, it can be simplified further into VTH equal to, as a function of VS, the voltage source, negative 1 plus 4AR divided by 3 times VS. For the short circuit current, now this is short circuited. Okay, so this become a single node. Okay, this become a single node. So then we need to compute the value of VX, yeah, the voltage across this R using KCL at VX. So VX one, yeah, VX one here negative 2VX divided by 2R plus VX one negative 0 divided by R. And here negative AVX, yeah, because this is current flowing into the supernode. plus Vx1 negative Vs here divided by 2R equals to 0. So from here, then we obtain Vx1 equals to, we express it as a function of Vs and R as well. So Vx1 equals to 3 Vs divided by 4 negative 2 AR. Okay, so then the short, KCL can give the short circuit current here. The short circuit current basically is ISC equals to this negative AVX. Yeah, the KCL at this part, yeah? Negative X is plus VX1 negative VS divided by 2R. Yeah. Okay, yeah, this is the current flowing through this node, yeah, through this node, ISC equals to negative, this current flowing out there, minus AVX, and this current is VX negative VS divided by 2R. So from here, we substitute this value of VX1 from this value into this value as well as into this value. From here, we obtain ISC as a function of Vs. Yeah, this is a bit complex. Equals to negative 1 plus 4 AR divided by 4R times 1 minus negative 2 AR. Then the Thevenin equivalent resistance can be calculated from the VTH here divided by the ISC. Okay, so as you can see, this numerator is the same here, so this will cancel each other. So this value will be become the numerator for R times 1 negative 2 AR divided by 3, yeah? And then the VS will cancel each other. This is the Thevenin equivalent resistance. So this is the final answer. The VTH comes from this value, the RTH comes from this value. Okay, so there is another type of questions where you need to plot where the value here, Rx, may be a variable that can has a range of value, not a single value. For example, find and plot the Thevenin equivalent resistance and the open circuit voltage here when the Rx is larger than zero, of course, yeah, positive, but less than or equal to 10 kilo ohm. So since this is an independent, the circuit only contain independent source, yeah, independent sources. So you, to calculate the Thevenin equivalent resistance, you can short circuit this independent voltage source, right? This is using the method that we have discussed last week. This is short circuited, this is short circuited. So the Thevenin equivalent resistance seen from this terminal will be the parallel of these two resistors, yeah, 4 kilo ohm and Rx, or equals to 4 Rx divided by 4 plus Rx. The VOC across here will be equals to 12 volts negative the voltage or plus the voltage here in Rx. And the voltage across Rx basically is, this is a voltage divider, yeah, of the 6 volt, yeah, to Rx divided by Rx plus 4k times negative 6 volt. And because seen from this pole, this is negative, right? It's like 12, negative 6 times Rx over 4k plus Rx. This is the value of VOC. So from here, we can put in Excel in the first column, the value of Rx, let's say from 0 until 10 kilo ohm with an interval of 0.1 kilo ohm. Then the VOC formula, we can calculate it from here. Then the Thevenin formula, we can calculate it from here, from this RK. So this is the plot. The blue part is the VOC in volt, and the magenta part here is the Thevenin equivalent resistance in kilo ohm. And the X value is the R. TH, yeah, the X value is Rx, the value of Rx here. So when do we need to use this kind of problem? Yeah, usually when you are for example using a sensor, for example a thermistor or strain gauge, whose value, the resistance value, changes as a function of, for example, mechanical strain or as a function of temperature. So then you can plot the resulting VOC here as a function of the variable Rx. You can plot like this. So this is the application of this method. So this is how it looks like, yeah, something like this. So in the left vertical axis, you can plot the VOC in fault. In the right vertical axis, you can plot the RTH in kilo ohm, the thevenin equivalent resistance in kilo ohm. Alternatively, you can also use MATLAB or Octave, yeah, like we have learned. So Rx here is interval from 0 to 10 kilo ohm, yeah, with an interval of 0.1 kilo ohm or 100 ohm, okay. Then VOC is put from here, 12 negative 6 times Rx divided by Rx plus 4. Then RTH here is calculated from here, 4 times Rx divided by 4 plus Rx, formula for the Thevenin resistance. And we can plot the X value is Rx, then VOC as the Y value, and then this is blue, and then plot as a circle. Then we plot again Rx, then the y-axis RTH. This is magenta with diamond, yeah, with diamond sign. Okay, so we can put grid X label Rx in kilo ohm, Y label in volts or kilo ohms. So this can be functioning. This is one. This axis can be functioning either as this fault, yeah, for the VOC, or otherwise as the Thevenin equivalent resistance in kilo ohm. Okay. Okay. So we go then to the more general view of Thevenin theorem. So you have a linear circuit which may contain independent or dependent sources with their controlling variables, yeah, as the part A. And from here, coming out two terminals, A and B, with a voltage, open circuit voltage VO and the current I. So this is the usual interpretation that part A circuit is having a source VTH and a series resistance, yeah, Thevenin equivalent resistance. So when the linear circuit has all independent sources set to zero, yeah, in the part A, so then the Thevenin, you have this Thevenin equivalent basically connected to the that one of the terminal, yeah, minus, and then this plus. So if all the independent sources set to zero. So this is, for example, one example that we have tried actually in the previous slide, right? The voltage AB, okay, something like this. And then when you short circuit this part and then open circuit this, short circuit this, this is what it becomes. Yes, this is 2R. And this interpretation applies when the passive elements include inductors and capacitors. So basically we can replace this, the linear circuit when it has all independent sources set to zero like this. And so what remains is only the dependent sources. Okay, so let me close for the